Hello friends, welcome on this video tutorial. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix, and in this video tutorial today I'm going to show you how to install Windows 11 Moment 3, the latest version, on unsupported hardware, unsupported computers, okay? So I will cover in this video tutorial everything you need to know, all methods to install Windows 11 on unsupported computers. The computer that I'm going to use today is on the legacy mode. I'm going to show you how to bypass TPM 2.0, UEFI mod, and also I'm going to show you how to bypass processor requirements, and then you will be able to install Windows 11 on your computer. In the end of this video, you will see how to install this new update, Moment 3, okay? So continue watching this video tutorial, and let's go directly to the point and install Windows 11 on unsupported computers. This computer is with unsupported processor i5-1650V4. It's a really good processor, server processor. I have 64 gigabyte RAM here on this computer, and I'm on the Windows 10 Pro 22H2. It's the latest one because I did the update and everything, and is installed today. Okay, so as you know, my computer is Z440HP. And then I will show you that my computer is not supporting, but I will bypass everything today, even if you see errors during installation. So what I'm going to do, first of all, I'm going to download PC Health Check. It's easy for me to go on Tips to Fix website, and here I will download PC Health Check because I need PC Health Check, and the link is directly from Microsoft. It's the latest one. I'm going to install PC Health Check because I wanted to see if my computer meet the requirements. So I know that it doesn't meet requirements. Then you see my processor is punishing me. I already have TPM 2.0 installed in the BIOS, and I did another video tutorial for that. You will see the link here on the cards. Just check my cards and see the link of the video how to enable TPM 2.0. But I will bypass this requirement. You don't need to do anything about this, okay? But even if you wanted to enable it, then watch the next video. Okay, so the processor is not supported, okay? I will use the first and the easiest method for you guys to bypass the requirements. First of all, let's go and download Windows 11. We need to have the setup, okay? Download Windows 11, latest one. So we are on 22H2, 23H2 is not ready yet, and we will be on the latest version right now. Select version, Windows 11 multi-edition. Yeah, I don't need that. Download. Here it is. I will choose English here, United States. Confirm. Then here it is, the setup. I will download the setup with high-speed internet. So we have Windows 11 here. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to mount this disk right now. I'm trying to set up right now. And you will see that we are not able to install Windows 11, okay? Let me show you that error. Good. Click Next. It's checking for updates. Look, checking for updates. If you don't want to check for updates during this installation, what you have to do, go and disable your internet. Look at this, guys. The processor is not supported on this version. Okay, so this PC doesn't currently meet the Windows 11 system requirements. Now what we gotta do, just we have to close it. Let's try the bypasser. If you go in the link that you have in description, then go and download the Windows 11 bypasser directly from here, then it will be the easiest method, the first method that I will suggest to you, because it's the easiest one. You don't have to waste a lot of time. Before we download this bypasser, I'm going to show you how I create this bypasser, just to be honest and clear with you guys, okay? So here it is. Author of creating this bypasser is here on GitHub. And then what you got to do, you will see this here, this script. Skip TPM check. I will copy all this script that is here. Then I will create a file here, new. And I will bring the script here, okay? Save it for the moment. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to replace this with name bypasser we have to put the extension CMD. But before we put the extension CMD, we are not able to put the extension without doing something. Look at this. You can't change the file type. What we have to do, go on my computer. You have to go on view, then folder options, then view again, then check this button, hide extensions for known file types, then click apply. Now you will be able to see the extensions. Look at this. The extension here is text file. I will remove the text file and type CMD, okay? Yes. If I run this bypasser script, I will be able to install Windows 11, okay? Just right-click, run as administrator, then waiting for 6 seconds and or press any key. Then now you will see that I will be able to install Windows 11. Now what we gotta do? In fact, the disk is already mounted. Let's go again here because I mount this disk and it's here. Okay. Double click on the disk and then try to click yes here and see if we bypass the requirements. Look, install Windows Server. Now I change the name. Remove this button here. Change how setup. Okay. In this link here, download updates, drives, and option fetchers is recommended. I don't want it for the moment, not right now, okay? Because if you have slow internet, it will be a problem for you during this installation. Then you will see a different kind of errors. And then I don't want you guys to see errors during this installation. So don't forget that to click this not right now and click next. And now it's directly checking my PC. Then, yes, you see now that we are able to install Windows 11 on this unsupported computer, okay? Then you will see these three options. Then keep files and settings and apps. Keep personal file only. Then it will remove all your softwares. Careful. And keep nothing, it will remove everything. Data, folders, files, and everything. So if you see this, keep files and keep personal files gray out, then what you gotta do, I did another post on tips to fix about this fix, why is keeping personal files and apps gray out. Click on the link there is in description and read all of this and try all the methods that I bring it here and make possible to install Windows 11 as is required, okay? If I click now keep files and settings and apps, then you will see that it's making sure you are ready to install. Then let's see the next message. So as you see, I'm ready to install now Windows 11 Pro and keep files and settings, and then click this button install. I will install it. If you have again problem and you don't see this window, get ready to install or installation interrupt. If you see that error, no enough space, but you know that you have a lot of space in your C drive. So what you gotta do, if you see a folder here like this, Windows old, what you gotta do, just come here on the C, just delete this Windows.old. Yes, I'm saying when you are on the Windows 10, then your computer is not updated yet on Windows 11. Then another thing that you gotta do, if you see that error, no enough space, you have to go here on temp, search here on start temp, then delete temporary files, then check your Windows 10 for temporary files, here on temporary files, remove these files, remove these temporary files, okay? Clean up your computer. I am not going to remove anything because I need this now, but you just remove these files and start the installation again from beginning. The method that I'm installing Windows 11 here. Other methods to install Windows 11 that is not recommended, I will show you right now how to do it like Microsoft will suggest. Then try to install if you don't like to install it with bypasser that I created. Use this method, okay? No problem. Then try. If it doesn't work, use the first method that I did. Let me show you exactly what you gotta do. So now let's remove this method. If you double click again on this bypasser, remove the bypasser from the system. Now let's try to do it like Microsoft is suggesting. Go to regedit. Then here it is. Okay. So here on regedit, we have to go in, as we are here on HK local machine, setup, system, setup, more setup. Here we have to create a new key in 32-bit. Let's try. Here is one. Then let's check the PC now. See? It's very important to choose 32-bit. Okay? Then click accept. Make sure you are ready to install. So this is the easiest method. And if you don't want to use the bypasser that I created, and look at this, we see this message using this method. You have to click accept here. We are ready to install Windows 11 using this method. Okay? Or change want to keep. I want all of this. Okay, guys, and then click install. And then if you want this registry key, I want to export it for you. And then I will upload on my website. And I will call Windows 11 registry. I will save on desktop. And then let's see what we have inside. Edit. I only need, in fact, here, this one. I don't want the other ones. I will remove all of this. I will only keep this one here and just save it. So if you want it, you just download on my website. Try and see which method is better for you. I did another video tutorial with three more methods to install Windows 11. The one using Rufus and the other one that is replacing uprisers.dll, okay? Go and watch this video tutorial and then find the way how to install Windows 11. All of these methods are covered on my videos, okay? So now let's go and install Windows 11 and see if it really works on my computer. So I like to use this bypasser because it's easy for me and it's working well, okay? So let's use bypasser again and let's go and install. Okay, I don't want to download any updates or just disconnect your internet, but it was easy. Accept, keep files and settings, and then click next. Then it will start installing and updating your Windows 10 to Windows 11. Okay, you will see this message. Now click install, and the installation, it will start here. This computer will restart many, many times. Okay, here we are on Windows 11 on unsupported hardware, unsupported PC, guys. Let me go here on properties. So here we are on the latest version. Let's go Windows Update and see if we have any update for today. But I know that updates will work perfect. Yes. So Windows Intelligence Update completed, security. It's downloading all updates. Let's say that Windows 11 is not performing well on your computer. So what you gotta do? Look at this, guys. You see this folder, Windows Old? When you are on Windows 11, don't delete it. If you are not satisfied with Windows 11, this is the Windows 10 that it was before. Now, if you are not satisfied, go to settings and then search here, go back. And then go back to Windows 10, okay? Here it is. If you click that go back to Windows 10, is this button here. If I click it, I will go back on Windows 10. But if you delete this folder, Windows.old, then you will see that go back button, it will be gray out, will be disabled, okay? So for more information about that, how to go back and see how it works, then see the next video tutorial that I did for this, okay? To go back on Windows 10, you have only 10 days. If you want to extend that 10 days, make it to 1 month, see the next video tutorial that I did for that. How to extend 10 days. This link, it will be in the description also and in the end of the video, okay? So now, guys, is the moment to update the Windows 11 to the latest version, moment 3 on 23H2 on Windows 11 unsupported computers. You have to go here on the Windows Update. Then on the Windows Update, you will see this option here. Get the latest updates as soon as they are available. If you click this, then you will see the update will list it here. Check for updates. I'm on the latest version of Windows 11 and the newer build. If you see here on the Microsoft catalog, it will be this version here, KB50264446. This is the cumulative update preview version for Windows 11 that it will show up Moment 3 or 23H2. It's not yet the official or stable release, is a preview mode, okay, preview. So let me show you exactly how it will look. If you want to do it manually, then I will paste the link. Then you will download the update manually here from Microsoft Update Catalog. Just click this button here to download. In my computer here, you will see the message that this update will not be installed because I'm already on the latest version of Windows 11. If you go here on the system, you see here about, I'm already here on 23H2 because I did the update. So I'm already on the latest version and I'm on insider preview on my computer. So here it is. Look at this, how it will looks in my case. I will see this error because if you see this error, you already are on 23H2, okay? But let me try on the other computer. So here I am on this computer. I will go to properties and then see and check which version do I have here. If I go here to updates, then you will see here, then when you do the checking for update, then you will see this cumulative update preview for Windows 11 version 22H2, and this update here 6446 is available. I'm on the unsupported hardware, guys, okay? And what you gotta do, just make this button here on and download and install, get the latest updates as soon as they are available and just turn it on, then this will start downloading this new update. I'm going to pause the updates now. If you don't see this update and you wanted to do it manually, yes, I will download this update. If you see this message that you will not be able to download this Microsoft update catalog, maybe it requires you to create an account and log in on your account, then download directly from my website, and then you will see this link like it's here, and then just copy and download the link and just paste it here. Then you will see that you will be able to download this update as soon as possible without need to create an Microsoft account. Okay, so here I am. Let's try now to manually update this computer, because maybe we don't have time to wait. So what I'm going to do, just try to install. I pause the update. You will see this message, Windows Update Standalone Installer for this update that we was trying before to do it. Okay. And I'm doing this manual update. If you have any difficulties to search for update, or if your Windows didn't recognize, or if you don't see this update 23H2 on your update area, then download it and do it like I'm doing right now, okay? Just install this update and then it will require your computer for restart. The updates are being installed and it's trying to initializing. Then you will see this, okay? This installation is complete. Maybe we need to restart the computer. Let's see and check here. This computer is not in the Insider program, okay? And now after you restart the computer, then you will see this version here. If you see this OS building version 1778 here, it means that you are on the Moment 3. So if you go on update area here, you will see that you are all up to date. Then if you see to update history, that this version, Momentum 3 update, it's done. It's already done, okay? On this unsupported hardware, if you go on the system, then you will see about, then this computer is the one that is, this processor is not supported, okay? If you have questions, if you have any problems, just write me a comment on a comment area. I hope that I explained this video very well today. And I took a lot of time to explain every detail and make sure that you install Windows 11. So thank you for watching this video tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe, tips to fix. God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial.